Greetings, everyone, and welcome back once again to Devil Summoner 2. It seems we begin Chapter 7 with what I'm already going to guess is a completely unnecessary and redundant monologue by Goto. The ancient scripture we found at the Three Cedars, the legend written in that scripture, luck locusts were abused in the period of warring states opening the gate to the abysmal realm. That's the true loathsome history of the formerly devastated Tsukigata village. Those dudes got wrecked pretty hard. The Gaiden in those days, the first Gaiden Kuzunoha, handled that particular disaster. He bringeth together an admixture of dark and light to form naught. The dark was the gate to the abysmal realm, or misfortune given form, and the light was the opposite, the manifestation of good luck, the Pojitron. Then there's the demon who can eat space itself, sealed away in the great summoner's hall, Tao Che. And for whomever it was that asked about this, yes, Tao Che specifically says, he said it in, I think, the previous episode, in fact, that he was once known as one of the four great evils. So yeah, he's evil. Supposedly. But he sure doesn't act evil. And the point that, I can't remember who it was in the comments that brought this up, but the idea that evil gods don't necessarily look to kill everybody and wipe out humanity and that sort of thing. Yeah, maybe not quite so bluntly, but evil gods also, at least the way they're often portrayed in games like this, which are very heavy on tropes, don't usually tend to have any redeemable qualities whatsoever. And Tao Che is really more of a hero, if anything, than what you would think of traditionally as an evil god the way they're portrayed in Japanese games like this. Anyway, after they got him to eat the space between the gate and the Pojitron, the two came in contact and nullified one another. And the secret art of getting rid of that pesky gate has been passed down through generations of Gaidens. Really, the Gaidens didn't have an awful lot to do with it other than serving as magnetite batteries for Tao Che, did they? It was really Tao Che who did the heavy lifting. Now the gate to the abysmal realm is back again in the Taisho era. The honor of disposing of it, of course, falls to the current Gaiden Kuzunoha, but he's kinda dead now, so I've gotta do it. The disease was too far advanced, etc., etc. So we unleashed Tao Che instead, and he went om nom nom. And that stuff happened. Tsukigata Mansion got squished, and poor Hanako got sucked into the abyss. Rippin' beef, Hanako. The gate to the abysmal realm that used to hover over the capital has completely dissolved. But now we've got this giant golf ball to deal with. Huh? Hidetaka, you're awake! You passed out after finishing the secret art. As always seems to conveniently happen when we need to deliver plot. I'm assuming that Tao Che ate up all the magnetite you had left. Oh. I thought you were dead. Someone's coming. Goto? Don't be so noisy. Raidou needs his rest. What? Oh, it's Akane. Oh, so Akane can understand what Goto says? That's new. Raidou? Oh, thank goodness. Nagi came to me. It must have been 2 days ago. Of course. She carried you here and asked me to take care of you. You haven't had anything to eat or drink in 2 days. You barely even moved. For a while, yeah, of course. We're not going to say outright we thought you were dead. We're just going to heavily imply it, as if it isn't already obvious. Oh, but I'm ever so glad. Sorry, but I was just in the middle of doing the laundry. Excuse me, I'll be going now. I love how she was ready to throw her life away for the village, and now she's just doing everybody's laundry. Women like Akane. I really don't know what to think about them. I can't quite decide whether they're heroes or tragedies. Maybe they're both. If you need anything, come find me. Remember, you're still recuperating. You shouldn't do anything reckless. God, I love this Digital Devil Saga-esque BGM here. Just fantastic. I got a comment from somebody who just found the LP and mentioned that one of the main things putting him off of Persona 4 and the Persona series in general, well, I guess P3 and P4 and then the newer games that have spawned from them, is the J-pop soundtrack, which I can completely understand. And this game, and especially Digital Devil Saga, are probably the best alternatives I'm aware of in the MT universe for non-J-pop background music. Just fantastic tracks here by Meguro. Now that the gate to the Abysmal Realms taken care of, the chaos over the Apollyons is over. But there are still several villagers with no choice but to take refuge here at the inn. And Akane is one of them. Right, her house got crushed, didn't it? She's helping out with the chores as a way of doing her part in exchange for the food and shelter. Okay, so, fair enough. Earning your keep. I can appreciate that. Quite a dame. She doesn't have to put herself through all that as the village chief's daughter and all. Hidetaka, there's been something on my mind. It's about Tsukigata Village. More specifically, Tsukigata Mansion, where you perform the secret art. Maybe it'd be quicker to show you than explain. Whenever you're ready, let's go to Tsukigata Mansion. What do you mean no one is here? Clearly Goto and I are here. Well, we got some case files not too long ago, didn't we? Didn't we? I'm pretty sure we did. Heartbeat of the Dragon, Pentagram. Well, we've had that one. Kifumi's Medicine we've had. Search of the Truth. Yeah, this is all stuff we've had. I could have sworn we got a couple more. Maybe I just imagined it. Although, now that I think about it, maybe it's worth going to check with everybody. Okay, well, I guess our objective from here is pretty obvious. Yeah. Oh, it's Taotie! He's still here hanging out. Sup, Nagi? Sup, cute little sheep dude? Thou art back on thy feet but 2 days after finishing the secret art. Thou art truly a Raidou. He's still eating. And we still have no idea what. Master's body is in the process of being returned to Kuzunoha Village. It may be a simple process, but I plan to make a grave for him at the Nameless Shrine. Well, that's good of you. Oh yes, Raidou, what do you make of that black sphere? It's pretty freaking ugly is what I make of it. Goto, of course, wondering the same thing. After you finished the secret art, it fell from the gate to the Abysmal Realm and crushed Tsukigata Mansion. It's depressing just to look at. I've been researching it, but I haven't seen any valid theories as to its nature yet. The gate to the Abysmal Realm hath disappeared due to the secret art thou hast carried out. That is certain. However, a sphere such as that did not remain on the previous occasion. Oh, so this is different. This is unforeseen, then. Well, now I'm really confused. What the devil is that black sphere? Now that I have borne witness to Raidou's recovery, I shall be on my way. Oh, you're going to peace out now? The rest is up to thee, Raidou, and thee, Nagi. No. Gaiden Kuzunoha the 18th. Yup. Of course. You're just going to walk away? Raidou, thy magnetite was quite the delicacy. I would most enjoy another opportunity to feast on it. That's got to take a few years off the old lifespan, though. I mean, it's fine if it's to save the world and all, but my magnetite isn't exactly a Sunday buffet. I look forward to seeing thee again. He is going to just walk away. The 18th, that's right. Master risked his life to protect Tsukigata Village. Wait a minute! Then, if Gaiden is dead now, what was that scene in the title screen CG with Gaiden, Nagi, and Raidou inside a Fukurutsubo with their swords drawn, all standing back to back? What the hell was that all about? That never happened. And clearly it isn't going to, because Gaiden's super dead now. Well, maybe it's just cut content. Plenty of that in these old games. Hell, there's plenty of that in new games. Anyway, Master risked his life to protect Tsukigata Village. Theoretically, I may not be strong enough, but I have to try. To leave behind honorable deeds and make Master proud. That theory is my hope. And the basis of my future. A voice can be heard carried by the wind. Furious voice. Future, you say? Wait, what? What was that? Was that you, Goto? No, where is it? Where'd that voice come from? Huh? Oh, not this crap again. Hey, everybody, we need a convenient vehicle to deliver plot we otherwise have no idea how to deliver. Look, can we just skip this stupid scene already? I don't need any more seizures. Thank you. Shinado, you punk! Etc., etc., Raidou. Oh, unfortunate, blah, blah, blah. I've come here as promised to fill your future with despair. I, Shinado, that is. The name of the black sphere that came from the gate of the abysmal realm is Abaddon the Infinite Abyss. Okay. I guess there's no other way we would have found that out. A nest of despair that flows infinitely from inside man like that of a bottomless pit. Hidetaka Miyazaki. By turning the nest of fortune called the Pojitron into hope, you warded off the gate to the abysmal realm. But now the nest of despair, the infinite abyss, has descended upon this world. It seems that the hope of this world's people is incapable of overcoming the despair, Your actions of assuming the mantle of Raidou and protecting the people of this world is the folly of one attempting to play the hero. It is the spark that burns down man's salvation. So his idea of salvation is the typical trope of villains wanting to basically destroy everything to supposedly save it. No surprises there, I guess. Nothing we haven't seen before. But wait a minute. If the Pojitron we used to close the gate contained the luck of only the people from Tokyo? Then how many other cities and places around the world are there where we could just get more luck and break the crap out of this stupid Abaddon thing? The idea that the world is doomed just because Tokyo's luck alone wasn't enough is both narcissistic and kind of doesn't hold any water to me. Only my actions are mankind's true salvation. Hidetaka Miyazaki. You no doubt have hope for the future within your heart. I will now take that hope for the future and turn it into despair. First, I will show the true colors of those you seek to protect. When you see their true character, when you despair of the people whose future you hold, your hope for that future will surely come to an end. You who failed to abandon the role of Raidou, etc., etc. Lament for the misfortune, blah blah. Normally I don't skip past dialogue in situations like this, but this is just so redundant and so repetitive. I've had just about enough of this force-fed plot. So it's Akane. I'm tired of this pain. Raidou, it's your fault. If the pain isn't going to end, I don't want hope. I don't want a future. Oh, okay. Well, that was rather unceremonious. Okay, another 2 days later. Oh, hey, Akane. Raidou. You went to the mansion. You had a dizzy spell and passed out. Nagi carried you back here. I warned you, you're still recovering. Don't go doing things like that. The way you refuse to listen to advice, charging out anyway. Hee 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 hee. You're like my brother in a way. Yeah, I wonder why. Raidou, there's something I want to ask you. A long time ago, I told my brother I wanted to become a pâtissier. Well, hey, you still can! But doing something like that professionally isn't easy, is it? No matter how hard you work at it, you still have to maintain a certain level of natural ability, and luck, too. I never dared to tell Father, but the reason I decided to wed Lord Tento, well, it was something that I knew I'd be able to do, to help the village. I've thought about that more lately, my reasons for going through with it. And the question I had for you is about that. What's the best way to prepare for the future? To work yourself to the bone, betting on your own potential? Or is it to know one's limits and find a role safely within those boundaries? What's your idea of striving for the future? Well, in reality, it's not that simple, is it? Sometimes you can't just bank on your own potential or find a role where you really fit. I can relate to this. And actually, I've had to carve out a path that lies somewhere in between. What I do now relies on some level of my own potential, but it also just happened to be a role that I found I was reasonably suited to fulfill. So, to say that it's one or the other in such black and white terms, boy, what a Japanese attitude, isn't it? But for the purposes of the plot progression that I want, I'm going to say betting on one's own potential. You've got strength inside. You're just like my brother. I can't make myself see things that way. Huh? You hear a commotion outside. Those voices outside, they sound like Father and the villagers. Has something happened? Oh, I'm sorry, I'm supposed to be taking care of you. You just woke up, won't you have some tea? I think I will, thank you! Akane is pouring some tea. Sorry for all my rambling about the future. I know you're trying to recuperate. But I do feel a little better talking to you. Oh yes, how do you like your tea? Piping hot or merely lukewarm? Oh, I don't even get to answer that? Come on! Piping hot or GTFO? Alright, well, whatever. I guess there's nothing else we can do here. What's wrong? Are you going out? No, I want my tea first! I wouldn't want you to slip and fall down the stairs. It'll only take a moment to ruin your health again. Well, I'm glad I have all these luck locusts to keep me safe from the evil banana peels. Which, oddly enough, I haven't seen since the beginning of the game. It's like whoever was writing the story completely forgot about them. Father, everyone, what are you doing here? Akane. Well, speak of the devil, it's Akane. We were just talking about you. Uh-oh. We were discussing this village's future, and we thought you might want to know what the score is. He looks really sad. You must have seen the monster already, right? Lord Shinado is angrier than a nest full of hornets. We heard his voice. He spoke to us in our sleep. Shinado? I've actually had the same dream. I heard Lord Shinado's voice, too. Listen to the people, Father. We should hold a village-wide meeting. I think it's important, since so many of us saw the same dream. For the future of Tsukigata Village and for Lord Shinado, we must bring everyone together. Right, for the future of Tsukigata Village, we need Akane to do us all a little favor. Wait, what? I told you I won't allow that. Father? Chief, what we said before, that was just speaking hypothetical. No need to get riled. Okay, this is sounding sinister. Anywho, Chief, that black sphere that fell on Tsukigata Mansion, we gotta do something to move it or break it or whatever. Just keep it away from us, you know? Why don't we go discuss this over at Tsukigata Mansion together, huh? Mr. Raidou, I just remembered. I got a message from Narumi that he and the others will be arriving around noon today. The plan was to meet them at the bus stop and pick them up there. But as you can see, I have some business to take care of. Would you mind picking them up instead? They'll probably arrive at the bus stop before long. Raidou. Your wounds still need time to heal. Don't put too much stress on them. What wounds? I just used up some magnetite. Say hi to Narumi and the others for me when you meet them at the bus stop. See, this is how badly I've been conditioned to just assume anything that starts with the letters M-A-G is magic or magic points or whatever. Hey, nothing went wrong in that marriage ritual, did it? We ought to have Lord Tento's blessing by now. I thought Lord Tento got eaten by Apollyon. Did Akane piss him off? Oh, no. So they're going to turn around and blame Akane. I have a feeling that favor they want from her involves sacrificing herself in a much more direct way this time. Akane came back to the village after the marriage ritual for some reason. Weren't Lord Tento satisfied with her? Hey, they say Lord Tento only accepts a pure gal as his wife. That mean Akane weren't pure when she got hitched? Wow, wait, what did it say, his delusions? Oh, everybody's going nuts. She won't talk to me, so I have to pry it out of her head. That black ball smashed up Tsukigata Mansion, and the locusts what raided the village were black too. Black is nothing but trouble for us. Now I'm scared that something even worse will happen in the future. Lord Shinado, save me. Yeah, he seems real interested in doing that, doesn't he? Wasn't there somebody hanging out here before? Oh, I guess they must all be at the inn. Well, let's take a quick look around and see if we can pick up any information we haven't already been spoon-fed by Goto. That song reminds me. My mom and dad want someone to die. My mom and dad said that too. They were talking about executing someone. Oh, well, okay, that answers that. Why do I even talk to this guy? The only merchant worth using is the Konoya guy because of the discounts. Heard that after you dropped that black ball on top of Tsukigata Mansion, you had yourself a good night's sleep in your own room at the inn. I sure do envy you, city folks. We get one room to cram into like sardines. Well, you outsiders are living it up in your... Wait a minute, how is that? The entire population of this village fits into one room at the inn? My theory is that an ancient civilization... Yeah, we've been through that. Okay. Well, I guess we can't help him. And nobody else is hanging out, so I guess... The black sphere that landed on the mansion. Is that the maw in the sky the insects are singing about? The sphere is calling us, huh? Can't you hear their voices? Maybe the people at the bus stop were called by the sphere. Oh, look who it is. What's that big black ball? Makes the buildings at the Capitol look like kids' toys. It's huge. Wait, if I'm right, that black sphere is right on top of... Wasn't Tsukigata Mansion there? I hope Akijiro and Akane are okay. Sup, dudes? How's it hanging? What do you mean, why am I here? Where else would I be after the crap that just went down at the end of Chapter 6? Did you come to pick us up? I thought Akijiro was supposed to come out. Yeah, about that. What? Akane's... So she's safe, huh? Ah, that's good news. I don't mean to be the wet blanket here, and I'm glad Akane's safe, but... Apollyon did come to Tsukigata Village, and that black sphere's still there. We're definitely getting hit with one unlucky break after another. But we can't let it get us down. We've got to keep our heads high for Tsukigata Village's sake. Right, Don? Right, Tay. Exactly right. I'll see you fellas later. I've got to go now. Need to see what's up at Tsukigata Mansion. That's where Dad and Sis went, right, Raidou? I've got to see them first and apologize. I'll do whatever it takes to make them forgive me. Thanks for the lift from the capital, Narumi and Tay. Yeah, because you didn't just take trains and buses here like everybody else. I think I'll tag along to Tsukigata Mansion with you. Moral support and all that. Tay. Plus, I can't wait to get a load of that big black sphere up close. Yeah, I'm sure it's not dangerous or anything. In fact, that's my real reason for going. I can still come, right? Like I can stop you. You'll do as you please whatever I say, won't you? Am I wrong, Narumi? Nope. When Tay decides something, she decides it for everyone. Just think of it as more bad luck for you. Hey, are you guys gabbing behind my... No, we're gabbing in front of your damn face! Narumi's not poisoning you against me, is he? Well, I'm glad everybody's so cheerful. Come on, Tay, let's get going. We ain't got all night. Hey, were you listening to what I said? Hey! He's so self-centered. Yeah, kinda like somebody else we know. Tay! We're gonna be at the Fukuroku Inn. Ah, look at them, lost in their own little worlds. I hope they could hear me. Yeah! So let's head to the inn and do another one of those blasted investigational meetings, I'm sure. Because we really need one right now. In case nobody was paying attention to what Goto said at the beginning of the chapter. Because, you know, why wouldn't anyone pay attention to that? No matter how many times I make that trip, it never gets any shorter. Looks like you've been through, well, quite a bit. First off, let me say good work. Akane called, and I got the gist of it from her. I was sad to hear about Gaiden. My condolences. Well, he really didn't make himself a very likable character, though, did he? Thanks to the Kuzunoha Devil Summoners, the gate to the Abysmal Realm over the capital is gone. You mean more like thanks to Taoche and his bottomless appetite for space? I left the capital as soon as I got Akane's call, so I don't know the details, but... The capital seems safe, though I heard you passed out. If Akane's feeling up to it, I'd like to reunite her and Don. Tei and I convinced him to come back to Tsukigata Village. That's not all, though. On the way here, I took a little snooze on the train, and I had the strangest dream. You mean the one everybody else has been having? I was there, wearing that mask in front of all the houses. The Shinado mask, right? And the version of myself wearing the mask said something. Hope not for the future. Stranger still, it seems Tei had the same dream. Oh, so everybody is seeing this now. And Goto did too. All these people having the same dream at the same time. This isn't a good sign, Hidetaka. Yeah, I'll write that down in the furball journal, just in case. Something up, Raidou? I know things aren't good when you and Goto stare at each other like that. Yeah, okay, so I guess they just communicate telepathically or something, then. Also, that stupid journal of Goto's is utterly pointless. Utterly pointless. Because it doesn't tell us anything new, and the story already force-feeds us so much rehash, we have no reason to ever even open the notebook. Well, let me finish, okay? I was talking about that Shinado dream. Been having a bad feeling ever since I saw it. Then Tei bursts into the room. Oh, there you are. For Pete's sake, I've been looking all over for you two. What do you mean? You went to the mansion, I thought. What's the matter? You look pale. Don's, he's... Uh-oh. Don's in trouble. Hurry, come to the Tento Woods. It's getting way out of hand. The Tento Woods, got it? Tei ran from the room. Well, that was out of the ordinary. What's going on at Tento Woods? Gee, I guess we'd better go to the Tento Woods. We can go whenever you're ready. Maybe I better take another nap, because I haven't gotten enough sleep. And I think actually now is a good time for us to close out the episode. So thank you all very much for joining me, and I guess we'll go check out the Tento Woods next time. Take care, everybody.